Let's take a look at the arm lock through the eyes of a white belt and how that changes as you work towards your black belt. Initially, you may only recognize the position itself. That's an arm bar. Look, his legs are over that other guy's body, and then if he lifts his hips, he'll get the tap. Or the guy in brown is gonna have a very sore elbow. Next, you learn to recognize the opportunity for the armbar. When James pushes up on my chest, I transfer the weight to my hands to make my legs mobile. I turn 90 degrees and throw my leg over his face. When you start jiu-jitsu, you'll quickly learn that you're more likely to get the arm lock from the guard than from the mount. I put my foot on James's hip, get one leg to hang off his back, the other one goes over his face. Then I lift my hips for the submission. But perhaps I need to use my forearm against his neck to hold enough space so that my leg can wrap over his head. I also need to recognize that whatever arm he's going to be putting on my throat is the arm I'm going to be locking out. Combinations also make things easier. If I go for an Americana from mount, his natural reaction is to pull his arm back into center line to protect it, because his leverage is so much better when it's in front of him. I learned to use this to my advantage and transition to a straight arm lock using his resistance. I can also attack his neck to threaten a choke. His hands come up to block the choke, and then I slide my knee into position behind his arm, flip my other leg to keep the position tight and allow no space for him to escape with. Finally, I throw my leg over his face to finish the arm lock. Another common reaction is for him to expose his free arm as I attack for the Americana. I need to be thinking ahead and make sure he can't use a free arm to defend my attack. Therefore, I'll make him catch his balance with that free arm, which leaves the original target unprotected. Now, if he drops his body weight and stacks me to prevent me from extending my hips, then I have to move around him. Don't fight his power and strength. Instead, spin underneath him, force him to roll, and finish the arm lock anyway. I can prompt an arm exposure from knee on belly, then swivel into position for the arm lock. Now I can do this fast or slow. Going slowly requires a step-by-step approach of trapping the arm, getting James to turn sideways, stepping up with my leg, securing his pants so he can't roll out, then swiveling as I sit and straighten his arm with my body. Because only one leg is across his body for this arm lock, it's easy for James to roll out of it. Through experience, you'll realize that this is not a big deal because it feeds right into a triangle choke. I put my foot on his hip as he comes up, which gives me the nice angle to finish with a triangle or an arm lock. This same transitional tactic can be applied when you're on top and working for the arm lock. Just slip your leg through his arms and let him roll into your triangle or arm lock. Or change to a compression technique if he wants to keep the arm bent. This is very painful. Or you can change the target and focus on his wrist. That's a classic way to open things up. Your other leg can also be used to break his armbar defense. You're not worried. You've seen all of this before. As your belt darkens, you realize the arm doesn't always have to be in front of you. In fact, you can trap it behind your tricep. And because you've done so many arm bars now, you know how to capitalize on any mistake your opponent makes very quickly. You can snap into position. Try something fun. Helicopter arm locks are also now possible. Use your legs to lift and rotate your partner, and it's natural for them to extend their arms for balance. Also, look for opportunities to take the arm lock as soon as you pass their guard. One technique overlaps into the next. That's the high level stuff. You see arm locks everywhere. Right off the guard pass. When you have their back and they defend the choke. Jumping over their guard and sliding into the arm lock. Defensively, as they try to pass your guard by throwing your leg to the side or even jumping into a flying armbar. The black belt can get it from anywhere. They make it happen. They conform their body for the situation. They're flexible and flow with what's available. It's no longer a technique. It's the punctuation mark in a strategy of eliminating movement options from your opponent. To know the arm lock is to have it part of you. It's no longer just a technique. It is your technique. This is what you're training for.